This video is a follow-up of my past video on reverse engineering, so make sure to have watched it. Click on the card at the top right corner in order to do so. The first part was more of a theory than a practice video, and I will try to fix that in this one. First, make sure to have a static analysis tool installed like Gidra or IDA, and a debugger like aXXo, as I will take you through the steps of reversing binaries. Before you go on reversing games or other more complex programs, you should start with crackmes. Programs designed specifically for you to analyze and reverse in the hopes of cracking them. Here I have an easy crackme. I will first execute it to see what it does before I start dissecting it. It asks for an input, and when I enter a random, it simply fails. I'll first drop in Gidra and proceed with analysis. Now we already have a high level idea of how the crackme behaves. It asks for an input and prints a failure when it is incorrect. And we can assume something like success when it is. We can simply search the string reference input key using the strings window of Gidra to find where the program asks for input. Nothing comes up. Well, the program is most likely packed, so let's take a look inside of detected easy. Well, yeah, detected easy tells us that it is packed, but it doesn't really tell us using what. Damn, I guess it isn't so simple after all. Well, we'll need to unpack it. Now, the packing shouldn't be anything crazy, and in order to achieve unpacking, we'll need to attempt dumping the image at runtime using a debugger like aXXo. After starting the program with aXXo, I will press the run button until some prompt shows up in the console. And to my surprise, the debugging stops, but the program still runs. Well, this probably means that the packer is indeed very stupid, and once it has unpacked the program, it executes it in a process apart from it. All we have to do then is just to attach aXXo to the created process and dump its image. To do so, simply click into Plugins, Skyla. In the new window in MISC options, disable Use P from Disk. Then simply click IAT Auto Search, Get Imports, and Dump, and give a location where to dump the image. Now if we take this image inside of Gidra and check for the string input key, we find it. Now if we check its reference and follow it, we end up in this function, which must be where the checks happen. So now all we have to do is to figure out what the key is, and we're done. This is the code after cleanup, and while it looks confusing, it really isn't. It's just Gidra's object code, which for a lack of a better word, is garbage. The key is fragmented in variables which, if we read their hexadecimal values in the right order because of Little Indian, and then convert the individual bytes to text, we get this string. We can then input it inside of the crackme and we get success. The crackme I have just described step by step should give you an idea of the process of reversing binaries. Keep in mind though that this is just an example, and this approach is just one in a million. Some programs can use things like Python, which is interpreted, or Java, which is emulated, or even .NET, which is just-in-time compiled. Also, some languages have compilers which generate different kinds of machine code for the same code, like Rust binary is very different from a C++ or a Golang. The goal you should aim at is developing the intuition required to reverse anything, no matter the goal. Now, my main area of teaching is game hacking, so for the rest of the video I will guide you through how you can start reversing games, but consider all I've just said and don't forget that you will not be able to understand everything you do right away, as you will need practice on your own with those different scenarios with crackmes or anything of the sort. When it comes to reversing games, the idea is the same. Analyze the program using a debugger and a static analysis tool, except this time we will interact a lot more with the memory, as the primary objective of game hacking is finding ways to read and write to it, so what we're looking for are addresses and pointers to things like health or player positions. Because games are much bigger and more complex than a simple crackme, when you pick up a game, you need to start from zero and gather information. First, try to find what game engine the game in question uses. You can do so by checking files. The process will be different if the game uses Unity or Unreal Engine, for example, but it can also use its own engine or a simpler one. When learning game hacking for the first time, I recommend games with their own game engines, which we'll call native, like aXXo, for example. target a game which has been made in C++, as their process is very straightforward. Some of these games are any source game by Valve, like CSGO, but I recommend the good old aXXo Cube, as in terms of complexity, it is very bare bone. But it still has a couple of fun features. Besides, it is open source, so if you get stuck, you can just analyze the source code and check if you've rehearsed it right. Once you're inside the game, try to find something simple, like the player position or health. To do so, I recommend you download and install Cheat Engine. It is a nice debugger designed just for game hacking. It allows you to look for memory values at runtime by filtering things like its data type or change. Like, for example, if the value of the health decreased or increased. I'll look for my health by entering its number, which in this case is 100, in search. Now, there are a lot of values, so I'll need to filter a bit. To do so, I voluntarily lose health by throwing a grenade on my player. Now the value is 5, so in my cheat engine I will filter for the exact value 5. And here we go, now we have a lot less value. You can now find your health in the remainings and do the same for other values like position. There's a lot more to it, but I won't dive into it in this video. Well, it's all for this video. It should have given you an introduction to reverse engineering. Thanks to all my Patreons for their outstanding support, and thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next one.